It really set in for me, I guess, by during Christmas break, where, you know, I was wearing a lot of these losses, and, you know, and really probably my mindset for these young men wasn't great, in the sense where, you know, I was wearing it, I was showing it, and, you know, then you continue to lose hockey games, but I think, you know, with where our team's at right now, I mean, we have 12 players really that haven't played a full season in the league yet. And even more when you count two of our 99s in Oberoi and Martin. And we're going through really the learning curve right now. And as you all know, the second half of the year, that's when it ramps up. And especially with teams that are in it and trying to win. And some good teams, and but our kids haven't. There haven't been many nights where I've sat here and I'm just like, boy, we got outworked, we got outplayed, and right now it's just a matter of continuing to push the envelope as far as stick with it. You know, I think everyone, when things go bad, I think guys tend to go on their own and try to do a little too much by themselves, you know, especially the guys that have been here before, you know, and I think it's tough on them, and I don't blame them, you know. It's, you know, a guy like Kyle, who's been here in Mods, you know, Kyle has been here for, you know, 3 years in a row of 50 wins, and you go through a year like this, it's not something you're accustomed to, and it's a different mindset you have to have on a daily basis where, you know, we're not battling for a championship right now, and that's pretty simple to identify that. But I think it's important to really keep pushing these kids to get better, and, you know, their leadership group and four guys that haven't worn letters before, and really helping to grow them into becoming leaders and really making this team their own. And you know, for me, those are the things right now that are important, because, you know, we're sitting where we're at, and if we can get a push here, yeah, we can make a push for that 8th and 7th spot, but I'm not concerned about that right now. I'm more concerned about these last 23 games and 22 games, really making sure that, you know, we're building in the right direction. We're not taking, you know, 5 games stretch where we are getting hammered, and that to me is what's important right now. We're gonna have our bad games every second of the night. That's just based on our experience. But if our bad games are occurring because, you know, we're making mistakes, or, you know, we're afraid to play the game the right way, then, you know, then those are things for me that we can deal with and work with. But if it's just for lack of effort, lack of compete, that's when we got a problem. I think it was important for me, and we knew the deadline was coming. And we knew we were going to lose two older, experienced players. And, you know, and certainly we had an opportunity to improve, I think, our youth on our back end, too, with the trade of Keith Robinson. And then the trade of Mitchell Byrne was the purpose of allowing our young defenseman to get playing time. So you really take out 3 19-year-olds out of your lineup, and 1 18-year-old who, you know, hadn't had a full season yet, but 3 guys that have been fixtures in this team in the last 3 years, and 3-4 years for that matter. And you kind of have to start preparing yourself for some nights where things aren't going to go great. And, you know, when you have 2 goalies that are new to the league and really haven't played a ton, and you know, you're going to run into nights like we did on Saturday where we're going to get some bad goals scored against us. And for me right now, it's not even talking about wins and losses. I'm more concerned about, you know, building this culture around being good teammates and trying to really instill some pride in how we play and compete for each other. And, you know, really the individual stuff alone, it's great at times, but, you know, for me, teams are the ones that are close. And I'm not saying we do have a really close group, but in the sense of how we play and how we want to play together and for each other, I think those are the things that you build championship teams around. And I think think instilling those things right now as we go through this tough stretch is what's going to be